Nova Scotia. Yep.
But anyway.
Jimmy, let's bring out your special guest.
We had a big guest on Thursday night, but we got a really big guest tonight.
Real big.
Yeah.
Let's bring him out, Bert Kreischer. Come on out.
The machine is here. I love your drunken Russian story so much, I can't tell you.
Oh, you have no idea what that means to me. Okay. You have no idea how much of a thumbprint you left on me artistically.
I am glad you're alive.
Yeah.
I've come close to that, but the Russians were a little bit, you can explain that, because I had the Colombians. The day I played for Carlos later in the Bahamas.
Oh, back when Tarzan was going to Miami.
I don't recognize you in clothes.
Oh, I can take the shirt off if you want it.
No, I like it on.
Good,
God knows and everything. I'm wired here, so you know.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like a DEA kind of informant. You know But it's great to have. So how did it go here last time?
Yeah, it was absolutely amazing.
First time?
First time at Red Rocks. It was a dream come true. It was super emotional, like just top to bottom. I had my wife, I had all our friends come out, and I got to be dead honest with you, I'm being sincere. Throughout the whole push of selling tickets for that show, I kept mentioning that I was bookended by you. And every one of my friends from Florida knew how much that meant to me to be in between Jimmy Buffett shows, to have all your gear on stage when I'm headlining Red Rocks was like the biggest privilege a Florida kid could ever have in their entire life.
Well, here's the first thing, because I asked my crew, I said, do we have to load out after the first show? How much shit did they bring in here?
Yeah.
And they said, no, it's the machine. I said, there's nothing. We got nothing. This is great.
Yeah, it was awesome. We made a few jokes about maybe putting stuff on your equipment, but it's nothing happened.
I already heard him. I heard him from Rich, my sound man. You use some of our crew. They're good guys.
We shared a crew?
Yeah.
Snitches.
Yeah. We had light. We lent you lights. They said you were going to pay me for it. So.
All right.
So you're going to go out there and watch this show?
Oh, my wife's first Jimmy Buffett concert. You have no idea how excited I am.
Oh,
she said, she goes, I swear to God, she goes, do you think he'll play Margaritaville? I go, I don't know, babe. I'll talk to him and see if I can get him to do it.
I don't know, Bert. Come on. That song? Yeah. No, I'm one of those guys that plays songs that people pay to hear.
Let me tell you something, Jimmy. Let me tell you something. As a man who has told the same story, the Russian mob story, in theaters for the past 4 years and told it here last night as a 13-minute story, that is because I go to shows like yours as a kid, all growing up, all the way into college, all the way as an adult, and I go, it's an event, it's an experience. And I'm telling you, every time I start that machine story.
Well, thanks, because you know, it's the same thing. It's just like, you know, you get those pessimistic kind of, everybody's got to find the bad in everything these days. And you go, you really get tired of playing that song when, you're mine.
Let me tell you, Jimmy, when I started, and I go, when I was 22 years old, I got involved with the Russian mafia, and you hear 10,000 people go nuts. It brings a tear to my eye. I go, that's what you get in the business for. When you start, if you go, if I could have one hit that anyone knows, anyone would ever recognize, I'd make the happiest kid in the world.
Yeah.
And then you get it, and I'm telling you, it's, you know, you always do a brand new hour, but you got to bring out the ones they want to hear.
Well, that's what I always said, you got to keep going that way. And I grew up on Bourbon Street. That's where I cut my teeth. And that was enough to understand that you had to, you know, it was about what they wanted, not what you wanted
to do. Yes, sir. Let me tell you.
And I know, you know what? That's what I love what you do. That's really great. So have a great time. And where's your lovely wife? Is she out there?
She's in the audience with a parrot on her head.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, good. Okay. Well, y'all have a good time tonight. Okay.
Sir, thank
great
you
to
very
see
much.
You, brother.
It was a all pleasure. Right.
We'll have to work together sometime, man.
Pleasure. Well, thank you. It was an absolute pleasure, gentlemen. Have a great
show.
We're
in Florida all in December. Come see us.
Hey, I will get you my
okay.
number.
Thank you.
Right. Thank you very much.
The machine is here.
Woo! All right, guys. That's it. They're ready for you.
No viewer mail.
Looks like we got. Let's check with Fred DeCordova here. Fred, we have time for viewer mail.
One. Two,
one.
Oh, here you go.
One viewer.
Now, bang! What was it like having two Mr. Utley's on stage? Is Mick a chip off? I didn't write this. Is Mick a chip off the old bong?
Oh, chip off the old bong.
Oh, yeah.
That's pretty good. I'd say Mick is a chip off the old bong. Yes. It's very exciting for me to have two Utleys over there.
All right.
That's it.
All right. So we'll see you for good ones. We'll see you from Blossom, Cleveland.
See you from Cleveland.
Yeah.
Where are we first? We're in Detroit first, right? That's our next stop.